people in about 600 AD, when corn was further south, that were in Mexico, were the people of the sacred snake, the plume snake, Teotihuacan, ancient center, educational center, religious center. Teota is not a Ho-Chunk word. It's an Indo-European word that means a people of. And out of that we get Deutsch, Deutsch, over the years. 4000 BC, it meant the people of. Wakan is a Ho-Chunk word, which means snake. So who has the borrow part and who has the root part, we don't know, but put them together and you got place of the snake. The symbol of the people of the Toltecs, as they call them, or Teotihuacan, the religious, very Puritan, moral people, stopped human sacrifice, had extended trade routes in Mexico that said went 2,000 miles north. That takes you to the copper mines of Lake Superior. And Tolteca was a term that meant he who works copper.
No kidding.
Put two and two together. And they had to get copper somewhere, and that copper came from Lake Superior. And if you're gonna move that copper to keep those people going, you gotta have guys in the boats. And that's what old Pomita said. He said, well, at one time it was a clear sail down from Lake Nipissing into the Chicago Ship Canal to the Mexico Gulf. But that closed off around 1200 BC. Thereafter, you had a portage. And one of the areas that was very easy was up the Rock River through Aztlan area into Horicon. And if you're going to have to portage, that's a good one. And there at Aztlan, what we call Aztlan, which is a park now, Pamela said this was like a station on the Pony Express Road for the river system by the priests of the South. People came through carrying stuff. They didn't know what they were carrying. But it was a communication route. So we shouldn't be surprised then that we have images that look like snake, as Frank said here. And we find a plume snake coiled up on an island over by Rock Lake, and Indian mounds around the state that look like plume snakes. The symbol of the snake was understood. Those people down south, of the Quetzalcoatl, that means plume snake. Those guys. It's like the cross is a symbol. The Christianity and the crescent moon for the Muslims. So, but then there was a squabble, as in all cases, and the Ho-Chunks talking about the wars between the Thunderbirds, that their Thunderbird clan provides the chiefs in historical time, between the Thunderbirds and the snakes. Snakes lost, they retreated back south. So, in these we call myths. They're not myths at all. They're shorthand versions of history put together in a beautiful way for people with eyes to see. And you can still see them. Just last couple weeks, Linda and I were going down a road by Devil's Lake. And there was a marker tree there. That's a tree made by the Indians as a sign. It's the language in it. It's been kept quiet from the whites, because usually it marked graves and like whites like to dig graves. The Indians found that out, so they kept quiet about it. But if you know the language, you can follow them. So we stopped along this road by a big marker tree, went in, and what do we find? A big rock snake. This is on a single sheet of paper, and I don't know how many you have, Linda, still left, but there's a few, I'm sure. So there, that's something you can see if you've got your eyes open, and you got a symbol that means something. You also find symbols of the snake over by Astolin Park. I don't know if there's any in this one, but take it from me, there are snake symbols over at Astolin Park. Now, is this calendar that we're looking at unique? Not at all. If you stand on Christmas Hill to the east and south of Astolin Park, like we're looking now, you look a mile and a half away to the sun setting over the big mounds on the ridge at Astolin. You got the same calendar. You've got a calendar to the summer solstice sunset and to Llama's Day, and then in the spring when it's coming up. Spring cross quarter day, summer solstice, summer cross quarter day. At other sites, Jeffers Petroglyph site, the same calendar system, that part of the day built in. So there's got to be a reason. It's an agricultural calendar. They're all using the same system of reference. They're all trying to survive by growing crops. And they all understood that what goes on up in the heavens affects our lives and what we do. And they all had reverence for it. Now, we can go to other sites. In the north, you only have the summer calendar up by Lake Superior. Up by the copper mines, they all close down by 15 November. Well, nothing after 15 November. If you've ever been up there in the wintertime, you understand why. And then you come further south, then you have your winter solstice alignments, like in Madison and so forth. So these people also migrated back and forth. And you can read a lot about what part of the year is in the calendar system. So, Astolin comparison to this site is in this little handout. If you're interested, Linda can set you up with a copy. Snake, if we got any more of those left. And this has to do with just the general geometry and some of the rock structure we find up in northern Michigan, along with a nice petroglyph of a ship. A ship, not Viking, it's too fat. Be more like Minoan, at a nice harbor, a mile or so from Lake Superior. And the fact that these people also built alignments from one site to the next. As Frank has said, from the center of that bird mound here to a big cairn up on that ridge is winter solstice sunset, summer solstice sunrise. And have you checked it out? Does it go to Devil's Lake? Yeah. And so the whole country is like that. Because of these stories, Ralph Red Fox wanted us to survey the Bighorn Medicine Wheel because he was looking for sites in Wisconsin that were in his stories and that got encoded in the Bighorn Medicine Wheel. And that's like 900 miles away. And we found the sites.